A question from Reuters. Thank you very much. Our question is, China has revised the law on guarding state secrets after expanding its anti-espionage law last year. The broad and vague wording of the revisions has worried some foreign businesses concerned that they could be punished for regular business activities. Will laws change further this year to create even more uncertainty for businesses? Thank you.
路透社, 中国自去年修订反间谍法后又修订通过了保守国家秘密法。新修订法案中宽泛模糊的表述 引发一些外国投资者的担忧，自己是否会因正常的商业行为而受到惩罚？请问今年是否还会进一步修订相关的法律，从而给市场带来更多的不确定性？谢谢。谢谢你的提问。去年四月，全国人大常委会审议通过新修订的反间谍法。 有外媒报道，这次修法扩大了间谍行为的范畴，会导致外国人和外国公司来中国面临更大的风险。在这里，我要特别强调，这是对反间谍法的错误解读。Thank
you. In April 2023, the NPC Standing Committee approved the newly revised counter-espionage law. Some foreign media claimed that the revision broadened the definition of espionage activities and would bring greater risks to foreign nationals and foreign companies coming to China. Well, let me make it clear that this is a misinterpretation of the counter-espionage law.
大家可以仔细读一下条文。新修订的反间谍法并没有扩大间谍行为的范围，而是在参考国际通行做法、合理借鉴各国法律制度的基础上，完善了间谍行为的定义，明确了非法行为和合法行为的界限。 增强了外国企业和外国人在华投资、工作、生活的确定性和安全感，不针对商业往来、科研合作、学术交流等正常活动。我们反对通过曲解反间谍法抹黑、破坏中国云商环境的行径。
If you go through the provisions carefully, you will find that the newly revised law did not broaden the scope of espionage activities. Rather, based on common international practices and drawing upon the legal systems of other countries, it has actually refined the definition of espionage activities and made clear the line between legal and illegal activities. The law, in fact, enhances the sense of certainty and security of foreign companies and nationals when they invest, work, and live in China. It does not target normal business activities, research cooperation, and academic exchanges. We are opposed to any attempt of denigrating or attacking China's business environment by misinterpreting the counter-espionage law.
前后制定和修改了多部涉外法律，并在本届立法规划中安排了多个涉外法律项目，为保护在华外国人和境外企业组织的合法权益提供了法律依据，支持市场化、法治化、国际化、一流营商环境建设。
In recent years, the NPC Standing Committee has formulated and revised many foreign-related laws and included many foreign-related items in the current legislation plan. We're doing so to provide the legal basis for protecting the lawful rights and interests of foreign nationals, companies, and institutions in China, and to support the building of a market-oriented and law-based business environment up to international standards.
中国始终坚持改革开放基本国策，发展对外关系，促进友好交往，欢迎并吸引外国人和境外企业组织来华商贸投资交流合作。对这一点，中国的态度从未改变，已不会改变。中国的大门对世界始终是打开的，不会关上。开着门，世界能够进入中国，中国也才能走向世界。中国将坚持在法治基础上推进高水平对外开放，在扩大开放中推进涉外法治建设，不断夯实高水平开放的法治根基。谢谢。
China is committed to the fundamental state policy of reform and opening up, and to developing external relations and promoting friendly exchanges. We welcome foreign nationals, companies, and organizations to China for business, investment, exchange, and cooperation. On this matter, China's attitude has never changed and will never change. China's door remains open to the world, and it will not shut. When the door is open, the world can enter China, and China can embrace the world. China will stay committed to promoting high standard opening up on the basis of the rule of law and enhancing foreign-related legal building in the process of expanding opening up, so as to cement the legal foundation for high standard opening up. Thank you.